You know her as the adorable Jess Quick on the CW's The Flash, but now she's taking on a more serious role. Her new CBS show, God Friended Me. Welcome, Violett. Beane, how are you?
Great, thank you for having me.
So I can't even remember like my own social security number most of the time, but Violett was here before, and remember we talked about her rabbit? She has a rabbit that's potty trained. Remember that?
Wait, you trained your rabbit?
Yeah, he's like a cat.
That goes in the litter box.
Yes. Yeah, it's amazing. He jumps on the couch and he's
he jumps on the couch?
Oh yeah. He'll like lay on your chest and you can like give him little treats.
Huh. But he got fat.
Yeah, like a cat. You just like train him and then when they go in there you reward them and
He likes blueberries and he got too fat and so the doctor said no more blueberries.
The vet said if he wants to live a happy long life, less blueberries.
Yes. So anyway, I remembered her from this because I remember her rabbit. And I do want to talk to you about God Friended Me because it's kind of a lighthearted look at like your relationship with spirituality, right?
Yeah, and each other.
That's a great point.
Yeah, I think mostly the show is about our connectivity with each other and how we can be there for one another. Mm. We're all going through stuff. You know, we all have like hard lives. And if we can just like help someone out one day.
You know, I always wonder if individual roles affect the actors that do them. And I'm thinking this must have probably really affected you, given like how you treat people on a day-to-day basis or just, you know, did it change how you treat people? And
yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think constantly being aware of it changes you. And for religion, too, you know, I was raised Quaker and I haven't gone in a while. But like just being on set and doing this type of material makes you think about it. I've given more thought to that since starting.
How did you, is your family still Quakers? Are they still Quakers?
Yeah, my mom is. Yeah, and there's actually a meeting really close to my house in Brooklyn.
Right.
It's a really interesting religion.
And are they okay with you being in Hollywood?
Totally. Quakers are like some of the most liberal people you'll ever meet. You can believe in any sort of deity and be a Quaker. Like you can be a Jewish Quaker or a Christian Quaker. You believe in five things, which is simplicity, peace, integrity, community, and equality. Mm. And you're a community together and you lift each other up.
That's very interesting.
Yeah.
Well, before we get too far, I want to make sure that we take a look at God Friended Me. Here's a clip.
You think maybe you're pushing so hard in this because you see yourself in her?
Excuse me?
Look, I'm just saying, you know what it's like to search for a parent and everything that comes with it.
Yeah. Yeah, I do. And I also know how much that eats at you, not knowing why you were abandoned, thinking your parents didn't want you. Look, she's fighting it now, but I think deep down, Heidi wants to find her parents. She's just been waiting.
For what?
For us.
You know what I love about this show is actually the creator said they wanted this to be this generation's quantum leap. And I think it kind of has taken on a little bit of that role.
Yeah, I think so. I often hear it's like a touch by an angel is what people compare it
to. But a modern kind of feel.
Yeah, and I think what's really cool about our show is that we don't focus on the angelic side of things. We focus on like, okay, there's a code behind this. There's a person that's behind a computer forcing us to do this, which kind of drives the mystery of it.
Right. Yeah. It's great. I love talking to you. Next time you have to bring the rabbit.
He's coming.
I'll bring the blueberries.
Yeah.
And we could talk about so much more and we'll have that. And maybe we'll even bring the litter box just in case.
Yeah. Yes,
we'd love to see it in action.
Right. Yeah. Thank you so much. It's so good to see you. God Friended Me airs Sundays at 8 p.m. on CBS.
Thank you, Violett.
Thank you.